Welcome back to the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. I'm Craig Maddock along with Mike Henriksen. Our second consolation round game coming up in a little bit here between Sioux Falls Roosevelt and the Huron Tigers. Coming up tonight, Mitchell and Pierre, one of the semifinal matchups. Of course, the head coach of Mitchell is Gary Munson. He is retiring after this year, after 39 years. One of the all-time winningest coaches, along with, you know, a good friend of his, Larry Luchens from Custer. And, you know, Larry, of course, been with Custer all these years. And, of course, they play in Class A. And Coach Munson and Mitchell with Double A. And during the Mike Miller Classic this last December, they decided to meet up against each other, Custer versus Mitchell. And a piece was put together for Dakota Life here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. And we'd like to share that with you right now.
In December 2011, some of the best boys high school basketball teams from across the U.S. showcased their talent at the Mitchell Corn Palace for the second annual Mike Miller Classic. The former All-State guard from Mitchell, who's been playing in the NBA since 2000, took the time to address the crowd.
We wanted to bring it back to, the best fans in the world, to the best high school venue in the world, the Corn Palace. Our goal all along has been to make this the best, most premier Christmas classic in the world, where every team wants to come play, where every coach wants to come play, and give you guys, the fans, what you guys deserve, an opportunity to see the best basketball players in the world play.
Fans were also treated to an historical matchup of two South Dakota teams whose coaches are ranked number one and number two in all-time wins in boys basketball.
It's a special deal, especially I know it's special for Larry, and he's excited about it just like I am. But the special thing is we both respect each other. We respect each other's program.
You don't think of AA basketball without thinking of Munz, because he has had unbelievable success in state tournament attendance and wins. And, I mean, nobody even, you know, comes close to what he's done.
Munson and Luchens have coached over 1,900 games in their combined 90 years of coaching, yet the two had never faced off against one another.
We were up in Aberdeen two summers ago and playing summer basketball at Northern, and somebody said, well, yeah, Munson is going to retire in 2 years after this year. And I said, really? And he was up there, so I went to him. I said, Gary, I said, are you going to retire? And he said, yeah. I said, for sure? He said, yep. I said, well, we ought to play.
Coach Lugin's AD, he mentioned something to him, and I mentioned something to our AD, because we talked to each other about playing each other since I was going to hang her up, and that's how it developed.
A week later, we had the game scheduled.
I think the unique thing about it here is having it in the Corn Palace. Basketball is a big thing in the state of South Dakota, you know, and it's a neat thing.
Even with all the accomplishments these two coaches have achieved on the basketball court, you can tell that their competitive fire is still burning strong.
I know what Larry's like. You know, he lost some players, but he'll be ready to play tonight, and his kids will play hard, and if our kids don't play hard, they could come away with a victory.
People have said, you know, you're kind of crazy, aren't you? You know, they're ranked at that time number one in the state, and they got all this size and everything, and you're going to go play them? And I said, no, it's not crazy. I said, I want to win. There's not any doubt that I want to win. But just to talk about this game for the next 25 years, I said, I'll be able to talk about it. And it'll be fun, and you just hope that your kids go out there and play well and let the score take care of itself.
And win, lose, or draw, you know, I just want our kids to play hard, and if they play hard, then I won't complain about it.
On this night, the Mitchell Colonels won the ball game, and bragging rights between the two legendary coaches go to Coach Munson. As for Coach Luchens, he's pretty clear on how much longer he'll be in the game.
You know, I always said that I would coach till it wasn't fun. Well, it's still fun. It's still a lot of fun. So it's hard to say. Somebody said, when are you going to quit? Well, I don't know. Maybe tomorrow? I don't know. Maybe a couple of years. I don't know. It's interesting.
Oh, yeah. Had a chance to work with Larry Luchens' state basketball tournament, what, 6-7 years ago?
Yeah,
out here in Rapid City.
Yep.
What a great weekend that was. And Larry was a great coach to work with, of course, during that broadcast. And of course, you know, he got so excited, you just wouldn't shut up once in a while. That's what makes Larry the passion of the game for basketball. Larry, the all-time winningest coach in basketball in South Dakota for boys, 722 wins. Coach Munson is next. 42 years for Coach Munson, 671 wins now for Gary.
And again, both of those guys, as you could hear in that piece, and by the way, what a great piece, and one of those stories that only South Dakota Public Broadcasting has the time to bring you, but both of those guys so passionate about what they do, and the number of lives that those two have touched. We talked about this briefly last night, and I know that Larry Luchens is similar to Gary Munson. They are the first ones to call kids when grades are down or when there's an issue to be had. They take care of their kids in so many different ways that a lot of times people don't see. If you only see those two on the sidelines, you are not going to get the full measure of the quality of people that they are. And in a great story on both of them, and I was over at that event at the Corn Palace this year, it was just a great night, an historic night in South Dakota basketball. By the way, you will hear more from both of those gentlemen on the documentary Kings of the Court, which comes up Sunday night here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. If you are a fan of basketball at all, I urge you to tune in on Sunday night at 8 o'clock Central, 7 o'clock Mountain, right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Another consolation game to come your way. We'll preview the Riders and the Tigers when we come back on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Or last night, excuse me. They will start Zach Cranston. He is 5'11 and a senior. Luke Carr, 6'5 and a senior. Spencer Staley, 6'5 and a senior. Dion Falks will get the start this afternoon. He is 5'11 and a senior. And Adam Zwanziger, 6'5 and a junior. So those are your starters, Cranston, Carr, Staley, Falks, and Zwanziger. Head coach is Tim Buddenhagen.
No, they were only down by six at halftime last night to Pierre, but boy, Pierre really put it on in the third and fourth quarter.
Absolutely. Pierre looked really, really good last night, and they did that with about half of a Zach Hansen. I mean, he didn't see much time, but he's coming back from injury, but he played terrific in that game, and so Huron is playing in this game. Meanwhile, for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, again, it was disappointing the way that their ball game ended last night.
Well, it went overtime with Mitchell.
Yep.
And the Riders will be without one of their point guards as Jeremiah Clark injured, twisted his ankle late in the ball game. He tried to come back, but just couldn't go with it. He will not play today. So they'll go with Tyler Howard, Nate Cole, Tom Neutrin, Brett Ledebor, Lucas Wilbur will get the start this afternoon instead of Jeremiah Clark. The Riders, 500 on the season, but they gave Mitchell a pretty good run for their money last night. Mitchell, again, won it in overtime.
Absolutely.
Speaking of overtime, by the way, Tri-Valley is in double overtime again today.
Oh, my.
They went double OT with St. Thomas More yesterday, and they got beat. And right now, Tri-Valley and Winter, double overtime, 3 minutes to go, tied at 65 there in Sioux Falls. You know, a lot of the broadcasts, the double A's here in Rapid City, the A's in Sioux Falls, the B's are in Aberdeen. You can see them all on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Can't be done without you. Rushmore Plaza Civic Center, a facility that takes care of 1,400 events a year with their brand new arena they have. Of course, they play hockey here with the Rapid City Rush.
As a matter of fact, parking may be at a premium tonight because the Rush are at home this evening.
They have a big pool tournament going on here. They have a big convention center area and 1,400 events a year here out in Rapid City.
It's all about floor space. Last year, Craig and I were out here and got a tour from the general manager. It was fascinating to hear what they have and all of the facilities that they have to offer people.
They also have an auditorium for orchestra concerts.
Right.
So yep. It's a very busy facility.
Absolutely.
It's a final. The State A's, Tri-Valley, goes double OT and wins today. They go double overtime 2 days in a row, but this time they win. They beat Winter 76-69.
They're going to be plum tuckered, aren't they?
If they don't go 2-0 tomorrow, I'll be very disappointed.
Yeah, no kidding. Just a regular game for them, that won't seem right.
The Roosevelt Rough Riders, Lee Taylor in his third year, along with the Huron Tigers. Tim Buddenhagen is in his 11th year for the Tigers. Both teams in this consolation semifinals. The winner will be taking on Brookings tomorrow afternoon. Let's find out the players, the coaches, the referees, who's all involved here in the second game here in Rapid City. We'll join our public address announcer here at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. And that's Kevin Phillips.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our second consolation round game today, featuring the Huron Tigers and the Sioux Falls Roosevelt Rough Riders. Let's begin by introducing the cheerleaders for Huron. Mackenzie DeYoung, Carrie Wintle, Callie Gilbert, Becca Gaynor, Kelsey Stoltenberg, Amy Ekman, cheer coach Becca Briggs. Cheering for the Rough Riders, Kelsey Brewers, Carissa Johnson, Morgan Moe, Samantha Nelson, Liz Ratzleff, Kara Sullivan, cheer coach Katie Hevlin. Now let's meet the starting lineups for both teams. Starting for Huron at guard, a 5'11 senior, number 10, Zach Krenston. Starting for Sioux Falls at a guard, a 6'1 junior, number 3, Tyler Howard. For the Tigers at guard, a 6'5 senior, number 24, Luke Carr. For the Rough Riders at guard, a 5'9 junior, number 5, Nate Cole. Starting for Huron at forward, a 6'5 senior, number 30, Spencer Staley. Starting for Sioux Falls at guard, a 6'4 junior, number 22, Lucas Wilbur. For the Tigers at guard, a 5'11 senior, number 32, Dion Falks. For the Rough Riders at forward, a 6'3 senior, number 25, Tom Nutrin. And for Huron at forward, a 6'5 junior, number 40, Adam Zwanziger. And for Roosevelt at forward, a 6'2 senior, number 44, Brett Ledebor. Head coach for the Tigers, Tim Buddenhagen, assisted by Tom Reed, Bob DeBoer, and Chris Rozelle. Head coach for the Rough Riders, Lee Taylor, assisted by John Peter Rines, Jay Wang, Mark DeYoung, Greg Henderson, and Matt Dykstra. Your officials this afternoon, Levi Pearson, Jim Johnston, and Jeff Schroeder.
First meeting of the year between these two, Mike. These two teams have not played this year. Roosevelt 2-7 against the teams in the state tournament. Huron is 5-5. But this will be the first meeting between these two.
Again, too bad that Jeremiah Clark is out injured. He is a very important part of that offense for the Rough Riders.
Wilbur and Carr to jump it up. And Huron gets the first possession and the first, oh, off the rim it came. Falks back to the wing. Huron had four threes in their game yesterday.
Yeah, Falks had one of those, but then he launched up about four more in a row after he had gotten one to go. But
Roosevelt did not hit one three yesterday. Surprising in that overtime loss. They did not hit one three yesterday, but Howard and Cole are your top three-point shooters for the Riders. Cole to Howard, trying to go back door, and foul called on the Tigers to start things out, And Zach Cranston will pick up the foul.
Trying to take advantage of that quickness. Nice backdoor look, but the foul committed.
Zach Cranston, first personal, first team foul.
Well, it's tapped out. It'll stay for the Riders. Wilbur for the Riders. A little bit of a wrap on his left wrist. He missed part of the first half of the season because of that injury. And getting the start today in place of Jeremiah Clark. Luke Carr picks up the loose ball. Didn't have the numbers. Oh, there's a nice feed to Cranston. And
great pass by Carr.
2-0 Huron. Neutron. He had 10 points yesterday. Head coach Lee Taylor says, if the other team wants to run up-tempo, we'll do the same thing.
Oh, hitting the floor hard.
Howard goes down hard. Staley picks up the foul for Huron. And Tyler Howard at the line. He had 15 in the game last night. 5-for-6 from the free throw line.
Excellent shooter. We talked about it last night. His mom, Lisa, one of the all-time greats in girls high school basketball in South Dakota, the former Lisa Mueller. He is a cousin to Josh Mueller, who had a pretty fair tournament out here in, 2001?
But he put up 60?
Yeah.
Was it 60 points? And
yep.
Set the all-time record for most points in a state tournament game.
Yep.
Here's Falks. Rebound by Ledebor.
Not a single black shirt around the basketball there.
Cole from the wing gets the three and one. We've seen that happen three or four times in this tournament, Mike.
Yeah, we have.
The shot is made from the three-point arc and fouled.
But that was also one of the shorter three-point shots that we've seen. If you're just tuning
it's
in,
true.
The gray area is for professional basketball. It's the white area that is the high school line.
Miss the old days when Rapid City had the Thrillers here.
Oh, yeah.
Some great battles with Sioux Falls, and just too bad they don't have that anymore.
But I tell you what, the Rush has filled the void. This has become a pretty good hockey town.
Yep. Yeah, they've already paid off that $30 million arena they built just 3 years ago. Well, Dylan Falks picks up the foul for the Huron Tigers. That's going to be his second. And he's going to come out of the ballgame as Tyler Hayek reports in. Hayek is a 5'10 senior. Already four team fouls on Huron. We've only played a minute and a half.
Man-to-man defense here. Huron with the mismatch.
Here's Ryder's Howard.
Take advantage of it, though.
Cole, three ball, too strong. Rebound by Staley.
And the foul on Neutron. He was trying to knock the ball down on the outlet pass, but picks up the foul.
Brandon Boggs in for the Riders. Brandon is a 6'4 junior. A lot of juniors on this Roosevelt team.
Yeah, very, very young. And really, this is one of those things where when you make the state tournament with a young squad, obviously you want to win as many games as possible and be in the hunt for the championship, but just the experience that you can gain for the following year is so valuable.
Swanzinger feeds it to Carr, to the wing. Missed shot by Staley. Howard, better make that to Cole. Gives it to Wilbur, and Wilbur hits the jumper from the sideline. Riders up 7-2.
You know, I was looking through the program, and we know about Lucas Wilbur and his dad, Jeff, playing on that 1972 state championship team for the Miller Rustlers. There was also a Carr on that team. I wonder if that's Luke's relative. I may have to do some research on that.
Ledebor with the foul. And we'll take a break as you're watching the AA Boys Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Halfway through the first quarter, consolation semifinals, Roosevelt leading Huron 7-2. Huron will have the ball. Luke Carr wears number 24. He averages 13 a game. He led the team with 10 yesterday.
He's one of those kids we've talked about. It. He's been on the varsity for so long, it seems like he's been around forever. Nice move inside.
Justin Decker with a nice strong move.
Justin kind of got handled yesterday, last night, so it's nice to see that young sophomore come back and respond strongly today.
Well, Roosevelt doesn't have the trees like Pierre has.
No.
Boy, Pierre is so tall, and they were very dominant in that second half last night.
And so athletic, but a nice steal.
Cranston will take it all the way off the window. He's got four. Nice move. Zach Cranston.
I thought that was ill-advised myself, but he pulled it off perfectly, hung in the air and buried it.
And Brandon Boggs hits a jumper from the baseline. A little freewheeling first part of the game.
Yeah, I like to see more of that. The point of the game is, after all, to put the ball in the basket.
Spencer Staley with his first field goal.
It's not to pass the ball. It's not to set nice screens. It's not to
what?
Run cuts. It's not, you know, put the ball in the hole.
Moody is in the ball game for Roosevelt. Boggs with another jumper from the free throw line.
Boggs with a nice contribution off the bench.
Trevon Moody, a 5'10 junior in the game. By the way, Moody did have a three-point shot yesterday. That was it for the Riders. Moody with the steal. They've got the numbers. Wilbur nice. To Kelvin Krause.
Nice passing. A great bounce, a great couple of bounce passes. It's the only way that that ball was going to get to its intended target.
To the wing to Hayek. Here's Carr. And a blocking foul will be called on Brandon Boggs. Actually, it's going to be on the... Yes, Brandon
yep,
Boggs.
Yep, you're right.
For Huron into the ball game. Swanzinger back in.
And also coming in, a line change for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Howard and Austin Sitter are back in. Also, Brett Letibor and Tom Neutron.
The feeling we're going to see a lot of players today in this game.
Good defense on the interior by Letibor.
Swanzinger off the window.
Swanzinger worked hard, though. Gave it up, got it back. Good defense. Nothing that Letibor could do there.
Letibor with the ball. Looking for someone to get open. That's Sitter.
Austin Sitter, the 5'11 senior. Again, Jeremiah Clark out of this game as he is injured.
Tyler Howard coming down the lane and drew the foul. And Tyler has hit the floor a couple of times.
Yeah, he has.
In the first quarter.
Not a shooting situation.
Hayek with the foul. That will be his first.
The fifth team foul on Huron, though, so it's not going to be too long before we are into a shooting situation.
Cross court by Howard, tipped out by Morrison.
Yeah, Lucas Morrison, the 6-foot sophomore. He came in and played pretty well in that second half last night for the Tigers.
Again, the Riders without Jeremiah Clark in this game. Hurt his ankle in the game yesterday against Mitchell. Moody with the runner. Oh, what a nice move by Trevon Moody. Any time you see someone coming wide of the lane and using the window for the basket, that's a great shot. And another basket, Adam Zwanziger.
What a feed by Tyler Hayek as well.
Roosevelt starting three juniors and a couple of seniors. Letibor and Neutron are the seniors, but you know, they're, you know, maybe score 3-4 points a game. That's right. About it. Roosevelt more of a perimeter type basketball team.
Foul going to go on Morrison inside.
But remember, Roosevelt, when they won their only state title 12 years ago here at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center, you know, they had a Tibbetts and they had a Giever. They weren't very big either.
And wasn't Nate White on that team also?
No, White. I don't think Nate was on that team. It was
all right.
Luke Tibbetts, Luke Giever. But, you know, they weren't a very big team.
Very true.
Tyler Howard to Cole. Here's Neutron. He's going to play football at USF. Oh, nice turnaround with a fadeaway, but he falls short.
And a good rebound inside by Justin Decker.
The pull-up jumper doesn't go. And Neutron, oh, Neutron battling with a Decker. And Tom not worried to mix it up. Fight for the ball.
And it will belong to Roosevelt.
Both teams have had a lead in this game. And the foul called on the Tigers. Zach Cranston will pick up his second for the Tigers.
And that means for the rest of the half, Roosevelt is shooting free throws. That is the seventh team foul already here in this first quarter.
Tyler Howard had 15 in the game yesterday. And he only has one so far in this one.
About 1 second difference in the shot clock and the game clock.
Decker falls short. Rebound Zwanziger. Zwanziger puts it up. Oh, can't get it to go.
But a good job of hitting the boards by Zwanziger.
Neutron will pick up his second. Adam Zwanziger, 6'5 junior. He's an 80% free throw shooter. Although he went 0-for-1 last night. In for Huron, Tyler Hayek. Riders bring in Kelvin Kraus.
The dulcet tones of Tim Buddenhagen.
Was he talking to the officials?
Perhaps.
1 point ball game here. Final seconds of the first quarter. The winner gets Brookings in the consolation final tomorrow. Down to Kraus. To the wing. This will count if it goes.
It is a two, but it counts.
End of one, the Riders with the lead over Huron on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Great to have you with us this afternoon. Friday afternoon, high school boys basketball. The double A's here in Rapid City. The A's are in Sioux Falls. The B's in Aberdeen. You can follow them all on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
And it continues to amaze me how many people still can't figure out how they can get all three of the tournaments on their television. Sometimes, you know, unhooking cable and just using rabbit ears is a pretty good way to get it done. Get the three SDPB, 1, 2, and 3 over the air. And
nice jumper by Nate Cole. Cole's got six.
But if you can't do that, then go online at sdpb.org. Carr with the beauty.
His first three of the game. It is his second of the tournament. Nice looking jumper from the wing.
Working that perimeter. That's Roosevelt's game.
Howard's shot is too strong. Staley with a rebound for Huron. Both teams going man-to-man. We saw a lot of zone last week at the girls' tournament. We've seen some pretty good man-to-man defense here in the boys' double A's.
Right.
And the tie-up, it will go to Huron.
Yep, alternating possession. A lot of times, you know, at the lower levels, a lot of times the coach will choose to go with the zone because you maybe don't have enough athletes that can match up in a man-to-man type of situation, so you're maybe hiding a player or two. Make the other team shoot the ball.
Reach and foul on Kelvin Krause of the Riders, his first.
That will be the fifth team foul.
Foul number 21, Kelvin Krause, first personal, fifth team foul.
Told you Roosevelt was 2-7 against tournament teams. Here on 5-5, they beat Brookings twice this year.
Nice putback. Great hustle by Tyler Hayek.
His first basket of the game. Oh, and Hayek comes back and knocks the ball. Oh, boy. That was a collision running right through the chairs.
Wow.
By Hayek.
Great hustle. And he's okay.
Remember, Hayek had a collision late in the game last night. Glad to see he's up and walking around.
And nobody on the bench hurt either.
Three chairs dented, but nobody nobody hurt. First tie of the ball game at 19.
Once again, Jeremiah Clark out of the lineup, injured for the Rough Riders. Averages about 9 a game. There's a long three.
Swish. Second three of the game for Nate Cole. He's got 9.
We've had some pretty entertaining basketball this afternoon, Craig.
It's been really good.
You know, that's, again, the beauty of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. They made the decision a few years ago to bring you the consolation rounds for each tournament.
Carr stayed right with it, able to get the basket.
Nice pass ahead. Trying to give it up on the assist was Calvin Krause. Just a little out of reach of Lucas Wilbur.
Moody and Boggs in for the Riders. Falks bringing it in for Huron.
Long outlet. Oh, great block.
Wilbur with the block. Carr down to Falks.
And Wilbur with another block. Back-to-back blocks by Lucas Wilbur.
Falks got caught right under the basket. Didn't have much room to get it up there.
And a foul whistled. Jeff Schaefer on the call. Jeff out of Brandon. Foul is going to go on number 13, Moody. And a timeout being called by Tim Budenhagen.
30-second timeout.
Well, for the first time, Craig, this afternoon, we won't have any halftime entertainment. The halftime entertainment has been postponed, so we're on our own.
The Class B tournament in Aberdeen. 2.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Woolsey Wessington leading Hanson 8-6.
I was just in Woolsey on Sunday morning. My grandfather, Amon Quelland, is buried up there. So since we were in Huron for the State B girls tournament last weekend, I made the trip up to the little country cemetery there.
Little delay in starting the A tournament because the consolation, one of the semifinal games went double OT.
Let's see what play they run off the inbounds.
Falks gets the screen. Got the screen from Luke Carr, but couldn't drop it.
And Carr with the offensive foul.
Yep. Luke Carr will pick up his first.
Nate Cole was covering him.
Couldn't tell from here whether Carr put his shoulder down.
Nope, we didn't have the angle on that at all.
Moody, back door to Cole. Back to Moody. Moody with the little runner. That's nice. A nice little runner by Moody.
Nice floater.
Cranston. Oh, throws it up and drew the foul.
He'll step to the line and shoot two. That goes on Moody. That's his second. He's seventh team foul, so both teams now in the bonus. Scoring has slowed down here in this period. It was 17-14.
First trip to the free throw line here in the tournament for Zach Cranston. He's a 68% shooter. Riders will bring in Josh Kirkwold, a 6'3 sophomore. Huron brings in Lucas Morrison. You're watching the AA Boys Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcast. Nice shot of the inside of the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. Huron, 6 of 13 from the floor. Roosevelt, 7 of 9. Nice close ball game.
Yeah. Again, we saw it raining threes in that first game this afternoon. Here, just a nice tempo up and down the floor.
Riders without Jeremiah Clark and Jordan Johnson, both injured, will not play today.
Josh Kirkwold, as you mentioned, into the game. That's his first action. We didn't see him at all last night, did we?
We did not. Cole from the free throw line buries it.
Basket by Cole.
He's got 11.
Yep, goes into double digits.
Swanziger, maybe took too many steps.
He did. He was working hard against the defender, took the extra step.
Ryder's biggest lead has been 5. Huron got out to a 2-0 lead to start the game. One tie here in the first half.
Moody working against that trap. Boy, nice job of blowing through it.
How about patience to get through the
The
trap, expecting a double team.
And then uses the quickness to beat the defenders. And a foul going to be whistled down low as Brandon Boggs out of position.
That's going to be his second.
And the big man, Justin Decker, 6'6 sophomore, will step up to the free throw line.
Shooting 1-1 here. Both teams with 8 fouls. Boggs out, Ledebor in. Decker went 2-for-3 from the line in the game against Pierre last night. Oh, he's going to get the rebound. Oh,
nope.
Good, hold it. Wilbur to Cole. Air ball, been caught by Moody.
Just the way they drew it up, huh, Craig?
Moody kind of sporting a little bit of a mohawk. Him and Jeremiah Clark with those hairdos. Here's a drive by Spencer Staley.
Wilbur tried to draw the charge, but couldn't sell it.
Riders up by 3. Riders 12-12 on the season. Huron 14-10. Oh, the floater off the mark, but Howard is going to go back to the line.
Yep, shooting.
Nate Cole.
He'll be shooting two. Foul is going on Zach Cranston.
Boy, Cranston, yeah, that's his third.
I talked to a guy yesterday who doesn't like this floor here at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. I love this floor.
I still think some of these kids get confused with the gray there for the 3.
I don't know.
Chris Phillips is in for the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
In the first game, I could see it. In the second game that you play out here, shot no good, but a foul on the rebound.
Here we go against the Tigers. The foul on Luke Carr, his
yep.
second.
And it's going to be a 1-1.
And at the line.
Excuse me, it's shooting two. That goes into the double bonus.
Josh Kirkwood shooting two.
Josh Kirkwold at the line.
Looking for his first points in a state tournament.
Eleven players now have played for Roosevelt here in the first half. Chris Phillips makes it number 10. Kirkwold makes the free throw. Ties the biggest lead for the Riders of the game.
Carr needs to play in control. He takes it to the basket, draws the foul from the defender from Kirkwold.
Kirkwold, 6'3", sophomore. Going up against a pretty good player in
yeah.
Luke Carr.
6'5 and a senior. Been contributing to the program forever for the Huron Tigers.
Zwanziger.
He'll come in for the shooter for Carr.
Falks back in for Morrison. Zwanziger in for Carr. Carr's got 6 points. Cranston's got 6. Zwanziger's got 6. Those three lead the way for the Tigers. Riders being led by Nate Cole with a dozen.
Tyler Howard on the dribble, but good defense by Huron, but now Cole breaks it.
Little finger roll by Nate Cole. Found a seam in the defense.
He's got 14 on the afternoon. Looking forward to tonight's matchups as well. Nice.
Ledebor able to knock that
yep.
away. And that's Tyler Howard drawing the foul. There's a nice shot of Lee Taylor in his third year. Riders went to the region final to take on then number one ranked Lincoln at the Lincoln Gym, and they came away with the win to get here to Rapid City.
That foul, by the way, was on Deion Falks, and that is his third, so I doubt we'll see him for the rest of the half. Yep, Morrison checks into the lineup. Falks takes the chair.
Huron has gone with 9 players here in the first half. Howard, all his points have come from the free throw line. He's got 3. Hayek to Zwanziger. Nice looking
nice.
Shot by Justin Decker.
He's going to be fun for Huron Tiger fans to watch these next few years, isn't he?
Swish that one right through. Boy. That was Hayek causing all sorts of problems. The catch by Morrison.
That was a nice catch.
And Morrison, oh, nice job. That's going to count. And 1. Count it for Lucas Morrison. Boy, he used that window real nice.
He really did. Again, the Huron t-shirts, you always have a theme, it seems like, when you come to a state tournament, and the Huron t-shirts are returned to glory, and they've got an awful lot of good young talent on this Huron squad.
First time in 2 years that Huron has been to the state tournament. They were not here last year. Morrison, 3-point play. Nope, didn't get it.
Nice job, the letterboard, to run that down.
Nate Cole to Howard. There's Kraus. Tried to go back door, but Ledivore couldn't control it.
Little too strong on the pass.
Wilbur back in for the Riders. Pretty balanced scoring for Huron here in this first half.
Yeah, they're getting contributions from a lot of kids.
Seven have scored for Huron. All of them right around 6 points. Swanziger didn't go. Loose ball by Staley. Staley is fouled by Krause.
Staley will step to the line, shooting two. Both teams in the double bonus.
Krause with a couple of fouls now. So you got Cranston with six, Carr with six, Swanziger with six, Decker with four, couple apiece from Morrison and Hayek. First trip to the free throw line for the tournament for Spencer Staley.
Spencer on the year, 70% free throw shooter. Got that one, buried it.
Five on the day for Staley. 3-point ball game. Riders led by three at the end of the first quarter. Feed inside to Krause, missed it.
Great interior passing though.
Chance to get within one or tie, but nope. Riders with the loose ball. Riders want last shot.
Yep, gonna wind it on down.
I'm thinking that the guy with the ball, Nate Cole, he wants to be the one to take the shot too.
Yeah, take a look for a high screen, maybe give it up and get it back.
Oh, Sitter had it knocked out by Staley. Carr back in for Huron.
Carr will come in, Staley takes a chair.
Here comes Howard, another 3-point. Danger, so look for number three or number five there. One of those two guys to probably take this last shot. Carr, deep three. Nice rebound by Decker. And we're at halftime. Riders led by three at the end of the first quarter. They lead by three at halftime here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Consolation semifinals this afternoon. The winner gets Brookings tomorrow for the consolation championship. And still more basketball coming up tonight. Semifinals, O'Gorman and Washington. 7 o'clock Central, 6 Mountain. Followed by an all-ESD semifinal with Mitchell and Pierre.
A lot of folks making memories, and that's one of the things that South Dakota Public Broadcasting has done such a great job of is archiving those memories. As a matter of fact, you will see the special Kings of the Court coming up on Sunday night at 8 o'clock Central, 7 o'clock Mountain, and here's a taste of what you will see on Sunday.
It's not easy to go undefeated, doesn't matter what level it is. But there's certainly, the teams that do go undefeated, you look back on the seasons that they did.
We didn't lead in that game until 7 seconds were left in the game. We were behind the whole way. And Rick Nissen got a steal with about 7 seconds left to put us ahead, 64-63. It's the first time that we had led in the whole game.
It's tough to go undefeated. There's not many, especially in our class or any class as far as that goes. And our top seven players that year went on to play college football or college basketball.
We wanted it to happen because somebody outplayed us, not because we let down. And so, you know, that's kind of what happened.
Yeah, our hats were off to the Britton Braves after that. They're a very good team.
You know, we almost got beaten in Montrose one night, and we had other close games. I think we beat Mitchell Notre Dame in overtime. And so there's, you know, it is special to go undefeated.
One of the folks that you saw interviewed there is Jeff Wilbur. It was 1972 that the Miller Rustlers picked up the state title. And Jeff is here watching his son take part. So many great names, though. So many wonderful interviews that were done. You saw Munson and you saw Thomas. People like QC Miles, who was a longtime coach and was actually on the board of control at the time that the three-class system was decided. People like Bob Swanhorst, who was a great player and an outstanding coach as well. Luchens, Munson, you're going to be stunned at the number of people that you see interviewed and the depth of the knowledge that this actual Kings of the Court documentary will present. Of course, the thing is, none of that, whether it be Plays Like a Girl, 100 Yards, 100 Years, any of those things don't happen without your support to South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Every winning team needs a solid support system behind them. Whether it's one of the teams you're watching today, or the station you're watching on, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. From high school sports to Red Green, the programs that you enjoy are made possible by the support and generosity of you, the viewer. If you're already a member of the fan club, Friends of SDPB, well, thank you. If not, joining is easy. Call 800-777-0789 now or log on to sdpb.org. Within a minute or two, you'll be back to the program and knowing you've done your part to support high school excellence here in South Dakota. Join us today at the $40 family membership level, and your pledge will go far to ensure that the extensive coverage of high school sports you love to watch on SDPB will continue. Catch the spirit. Join the Friends team today.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. We are at halftime of the AA boys basketball tournament. Roosevelt leading Huron 34-31. Listen to some of these names from the past. That's always fun to look through the program, see some of these All-State teams. In 1972, Chad Nelson of Yankton, Rick Nissen of Miller, Tom Schmidt of Aberdeen-Roncalli, Kim Templeton of Miller, Dwight Iverson of Vermilion, Mark Graham of Mitchell, Bob Utecht of Aberdeen Central, Ralph Overton of Rapid City Stevens. 1982, Troy Schaefer of Pierre, Kelly McGuire of Central, Jeff Peterson of Madison, Brad Ferry of Lincoln, Doug Smith of Pierre. So many great names through the history of South Dakota, and so many memories are going to be brought back with Kings of the Court coming your way on Sunday night here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We are at halftime as Roosevelt leads Miller 34-31. We're back to tip off the second half after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Both teams scored 17 points in the second quarter. Riders hold on with that three-point lead. And sure looks like both teams will go with their five starters.
Yeah, I'm not sure where Roosevelt was. They just now came out of the locker. Not going to get a whole lot of shots in here. But they shot 65% in that first half, Craig. So
13 of 20 from the floor. 2 for 5 beyond the arc. 6 of 10 from the free throw line, 5 turnovers. Huron shot 46%, 12 of 26 from the floor, 1 of 2 beyond the three-point arc, 6 of 10 from the free throw line. They had 5 turnovers as well, so pretty even.
And by the way, I did a little research. Jeff Wilbur is here, played on the Miller Rustlers. We've mentioned that his son Lucas plays for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. And I went and talked to him, and indeed, Luke Carr's uncle played for that Miller Rustler team back in 1972. The Carrs are from Miller. It was his uncle, John, that was on that team in 1972. So we've got all sorts of history in 2012.
Great bloodlines there.
Yeah. I mean, it's just phenomenal how many, and part of that is the fact that you and I are advancing in years as well, but how many of these kids in this tournament had dads that that played, or moms that were terrific players as well.
Riders have Howard, Cole, Wilbur, Neutrin, Ledebor. First five in there. Huron also with their first five. Air ball caught by Carr, along with Cranston, Staley, Falks, and Zwanziger.
Carr. Way up?
No, no. Will not count.
Fouled on the drive.
Foul on Ledebor. That will be his second.
First team foul of the half.
Huron led it 2-0 to start the game. Roosevelt took the lead then on a three, but then since then, they were tied at 19. The Riders have had the lead since. Carr wants three ball.
Followed his own rebound. Shot. Love that. Love that.
Nobody there to block him out after the shot. Made it look easy. He's got nine. We've seen that a couple of times. The guys following their shots, blocked out, and they get their own rebound and put it in. Howard, his three is too strong. Run down by Falks.
Falks with three fouls. He's got to be careful. And he'll step to the line as he was fouled, actually, by Nate Cole.
Cole picks up his second.
He looked a little out of control heading down the floor. I was a little afraid he was going to get a charge.
Tim Buddenhagen, head coach of the Huron Tigers, 11th year. First trip to the line today for DeLon. Went 2-for-2 yesterday.
Ledebor will check out of the lineup, and Brandon Boggs comes back in for the Rough Riders.
Five Riders have two fouls. Everybody else, one or none. Two Huron players with three fouls, Cranston and Falks, and a timeout taken by Lee Taylor of the Riders.
You know, we've been talking a lot about that program coming up on Sunday night here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, but remember, there's plenty of other opportunities. As a matter of fact, coming up on Saturday afternoon following our consolation round coverage, the flyover program of South Dakota. It is unbelievable. Over South Dakota is the title. South Dakota has been called the land of infinite variety, and the splendor and majesty of the state is in full bloom. It's a unique bird's eye view over South Dakota. It will air at 4:30 Central, 3:30 Mountain, right after our coverage tomorrow afternoon. I've seen that and give it rave reviews. And you know, a lot of times the Black Hills gets the credit for being the most beautiful part of the state, but when you see this, you will think that where you live is also the most beautiful part of the state. It is a terrific special.
Huron has retaken the lead. Nice entry pass.
Oh,
that was blocked by Staley.
Good defensive help by Staley.
Winner gets Brookings tomorrow in the consolation championship. Entry pass, Howard.
Got his own rebound somehow.
Tapped out. Luke Carr coming in. Oh, he didn't get it to go. Neutrin. Here is Boggs. Oh,
he walked
with it.
I think he was trying to decide whether or not he was going to dunk. And in the meantime, couldn't quite figure out the steps, so he used a few extra.
Roosevelt has been a consolation champ twice. Most recently in 2010. Huron hasn't been a consolation champ since 1991, but they've done it four times.
Nice drive.
Branston will draw the foul. Yeah, the pace of the game is a lot different than it was early in the first quarter.
Yeah, and that happens as teams make adjustments and not allowing them to do what they were doing earlier in the game.
Of Cranston now 3-for-3 from the line.
And that foul was on Tyler Howard. It was his, or excuse me, that, yeah.
He's got three.
Yep.
First Ryder with three fouls. Zach Cranston has 7 points. Ryder's trying to tie this one. Nice little behind-the-back pass by Boggs. Down low to Neutron. Neutron with a jumper. Neutron's first field goal of the game. He had 10 yesterday, and we're tied at 36.
Neutron, we've mentioned it, big part of that Roosevelt Rough Rider championship football team. And Carr with the basket and one.
Boggs will check that. That's going to be on Neutron, his third. Huron with a chance to take their largest lead of the game?
I think so. Yep.
Fire up on the Huron. Let's go.
Well, I got a question for you. I had a couple people ask me. Here's your kid.
Again, out of the ball game is Jeremiah Clark. He's a very integral part of that offense for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. He injured his ankle late in the game yesterday.
Cole draws the foul.
And it is a shooting foul.
Folks is going to be the first Huron Tiger to get his fourth
yep.
foul. Shooting foul for Nate Cole. He's going to get a couple. 2-for-3 here on the day. Nate Cole averages 10 points a game. Only had two in their overtime loss to Mitchell last night. He's got 15 today. You're watching the AA Boys Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Everything old is new again. Central fans having fun at the ball game this afternoon. Sticking around after their team was defeated today.
Huron is being led by Luke Carr with 11. Check that, Luke Carr officially with 10. Riders, no, Nate Cole with 15. Riders move into a 2-3 zone.
Run down by Carr, very fortunate there.
Zwanziger falls short. And the foul on Justin Decker. His first.
That's his first. Second team foul.
Riders led by three at the end of the first quarter. They led by three at halftime. Near halfway through the third, Huron has taken the lead for the only the second time. Ledebor, the lefty, hits the three.
That's some found points right there.
Only his fourth three of the season. And they retake the lead.
This zone kind of confusing Huron a little bit.
Cranston from the free throw line.
Nice job.
That's a great shot to take.
Yep,
right there.
Absolutely. We saw Odegaard do the same thing for Brookings yesterday against his zone. Just penetrate it right at the top. Go in and crease the defense. And take that shorter.
Tyler jumper. Hayek with the foul. Huron brings in Staley and Morrison. Zwanziger and Hayek go out.
Lucas Morrison, also number 30, Spencer Staley.
Huron at one time, Mike, you know, end of the season, they got a nice 7-8 game win streak before they ran into Mitchell in the playoffs.
Foul is going to go on Luke Carr.
That would be his third. At the line, Tyler Howard. He is 3 of 5 from the line here this afternoon.
Both teams with 4 team fouls. Well, that one rattles out. Lee Taylor, head coach.
Four points on the day for Tyler Howard. As the Riders have taken the lead. Timeout by Coach Budenhagen of the Huron Tigers.
Once again, we want to take an opportunity to thank the folks here at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center. Always fun coming to Rapid. You know, and we need to remind people, because I always hear this, Craig, and I know you hear the same thing. People say, well, why did you choose that tournament to do? Well, we don't choose which tournaments that we're going to go to. The tournament that is on SDPB1, that is predetermined by the State High School Activities Association. Next year, I can tell you, for the boys tournament, we will be up at Aberdeen. The following year, we will be in, for the B. The following year, we will be in Sioux Falls for the boys A tournament. It's rotating around. This year we did the girls B. Next year it will be the girls A tournament that will be on the main channel. So that's all predetermined. But again, the expanded coverage that South Dakota Public Broadcasting brings you, you can have access to all 3 tournaments in all 12 games from each location.
Jumper too far for Staley, and loose ball by Wilbur. Roosevelt lost in overtime to Mitchell last night. Huron losing to Pierre to get into the consolation round. Nate Cole going to go back to the free throw line. Been a busy guy at the line today.
Foul goes on Decker. That's his second, the 5th team foul on Huron.
Cole 4 of 6 from the line as Huron will make some changes. Zwanziger back in. Hayek is back in. Roosevelt brings Moody in.
So again, Jeremiah Clark injured late in that game yesterday with a twisted ankle. Not able to go today for the Rough Riders.
17 for Nate Cole. Nobody else in double figures for the Riders. Riders' biggest lead has been 5. Huron's biggest lead has been 2, tied 3 times. Oh, a lot of traffic down there for Morrison.
Yep, he forced that issue.
Moody to Cole. Cole leaves it for Neutron. And that's tipped away, and the Huron Tigers, oh, that's stolen by Neutron.
And then he's
fouled by Hayek.
That was a wild sequence. We have it. No, we don't. Yes, we do. No, we don't.
Huron brings into the ballgame Caleb Carr, a 6'6 sophomore.
And Calvin Krause will check into the lineup for the Rough Riders.
It's the first time we've seen Caleb in the tournament. Did Carr get in last night?
No, you're right.
Huron now has gone with 10 players in the ball game. Is a bit of a hack on that one on Cole.
Staley with the foul. And that will be the 7th team foul on Huron. So Roosevelt at the free throw line the rest of the way.
Riders have gone with 11 players today. Cranston back in for the Tigers. Staley out. Nineteen for Nate Cole.
He has been the offense today. I think that Roosevelt is going to need some more balance, though, if they want to finish this one out.
Nate Cole, 6 of 8 from the free throw line. Thought about a three. Instead, short range jumper falls short. Morrison keeps it alive.
Nice job on the offensive glass there by the sophomore.
Who wants it?
Caleb Carr, the 6'6 sophomore, doing work on the offensive glass.
Wilbur got the ball and then fouled.
Fouls number 40 out of Swanziger. That's his first.
Swanziger picks up his first. And the Riders are in the bonus for the rest of the half. Lucas Wilbur, 2 for 2 yesterday from the line, 60% shooter. Tyler Howard back in for Roosevelt. Cole will take a rest. Make that 4 points on the day for Wilbur. Biggest lead of the game for Roosevelt. Riders have scored 13 points in this third quarter. Huron has scored 9. Wilbur tips it out.
Wow. Great hustle by Wilbur.
Moody, too strong. Morrison up to Cranston. 2-on-2. Cranston will take it all the way, and he drew the foul.
Didn't have numbers and didn't have a real good angle to the basket.
Trayvon Moody, that's his third.
Got bailed out by Moody, committing the foul. Luke Carr and Staley come back into the ball game for Huron. Morrison taking a chair, as is the younger Carr. Caleb
leaves Cranston open, and nice three-point jumper by Cranston.
They really needed that shot.
He's got 12.
Roosevelt was threatening to stretch this thing out.
Second Tiger in double figures. Shot clock in the game clock. Oh, they call 5 seconds on Moody.
If you're not familiar, you have to make an advancement towards the basket if you are being guarded closely within 5 seconds. He did not do that, and so turn it over to Huron.
8 turnovers on the Riders, 6 on Huron. Final seconds of the third.
Wide left.
You're watching the AA Boys Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. I'm Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, along with Mike Henriksen, SportsMax Radio, and calling all sports.
Yep, I'm double dipping.
No, nice, warm, in fact, some spots, a hot day across South Dakota.
Yes, it is.
Not very often we can say that.
No.
On March 16th.
No, there's been a lot of times where people have been coming back from a tournament in Rapid City and ended up spending the night at the gym in Murdo.
80 degrees in Sioux Falls this afternoon, a record high.
Yep, 78 right now here in Rapid.
Nice rebound by Carr. Wants to put it back. Didn't get it to roll. Got his own rebound. Neutron. Uh-oh. Neutron's going to get called. He got somebody with the elbow, and 3 here on Tigers on the floor.
That's an intentional foul. And that means that it will be the foul on Neutron.
His 4th.
It will be a shooter will step to the line and shoot 2, and then Huron will get the basketball.
And that is his fourth personal.
Chance for Huron to take the lead on this possession.
They looked like Roosevelt was going to stretch that lead out just a few minutes ago.
Oh. Zwanziger, an 80% free throw shooter, misses his first one today. He's 2 for 3 from the line.
Missed them both.
Huron will keep the ball.
A great opportunity there. Goes by the wayside. Neutron will take a chair.
And he'll play football for USF this fall. Carr got his own rebound. Oh, he missed the point blank shot. Zwanziger with the finish. He's got 8.
Nice job by Huron. It looked for a moment that they were going to let that golden opportunity go by with no points. But Zwanziger able to cash in at least for a couple.
Huron is winning the rebound battle, 22-18.
Great defensive block by Carr, not just a score. A couple of those guys going after the ball looked like they were holding hands.
Nice feed down low to Kraus. He's fouled.
Stepping to the free throw line.
Tyler Hayek has picked up his fourth. So you got Hayek and Falks with 4 for Huron. Cranston and Carr have 3.
Reminder, they're coming up tonight, semifinals. 6 o'clock Mountain, 7 o'clock Central. Sioux Falls, Washington, and the electric Joey Habtemariam taking on 2-time defending state champs, the O'Gorman Knights.
Lettebor couldn't hold it. Zwanziger out to Cranston.
And following that game, the Pier Governors and the Mitchell Colonels.
Nice teams. Kiss by Cranston.
Great drive. 2 teams that have just been terrific all season long. You are going to see a great array of talent coming your way tonight from the AA tournament in Rapid City.
Wilbur for 3.
Oh, what a big shot.
3. Wilbur with a, he's got 7.
Again, those are found points, Craig.
Cranston wants 3 ball. He's got 14 points. Wilbur. And the foul. Nate Cole again drew it.
Yep, and is that, if that's Carr, is that his fourth?
Yes, Luke Carr with 4 fouls.
And the 10th team foul. So Roosevelt will be in the double bonus. Each time a foul is committed, Roosevelt will be going to the line to shoot 2.
Cole 7 of 9 from the field or from the free throw line. Add another one.
Justin Decker.
Justin Decker will check back into the lineup for the Huron Tigers.
Ooh. 21 for Nate Cole, leading scorer for the Riders. Carr feeding into the corner to Falks.
That time the feed by Nate Cole, he got it down low to Lettebor, but Lettebor really wasn't in any position to do anything with the ball where Cole got it to him. They got lucky getting that ball knocked out of bounds.
Only one Rider in double figures. And that's Nate Cole. Kraus challenged at the shot there. Falks has fouled out.
Yep.
He started today, Elon Falks. He did start the ball game today. He will foul out with 2 free throws.
Dion at 5'11 was challenging the 6'5 sophomore. And that was a battle that the 6'5 sophomore is going to win.
Tie is the biggest lead of the game for Roosevelt. Kraus with five.
Good quick movement around that perimeter against the zone.
Carr missed the basket. On the run out, up to Kraus with the lefty.
Great pass that time by Nate Cole.
10-point ball game.
The perfect spot to put that pass.
Foul on the Huron Tigers.
That's going to go on Zach Cranston.
That's his fourth. Foul situation putting Huron into a strange spot here with 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Cranston with four, Carr with four, Hayek with four. Folks has already fouled out. Roosevelt, Neutron with four, Howard with three. Everybody else two or less.
Morrison checks into the ball game.
When it comes to all the teams in the state tournament, Roosevelt has the highest free throw shooting percentage among the teams here, 69%. Huron is next with 68%.
Roosevelt stretches that out to 12-point lead. Nice put back by Carr.
He's got 13. Boggs will score.
Nice putback by Boggs.
Boggs able to pick up the loose ball. Three on two. Wilbur.
A very nice job of running the floor by Boggs, the 6'4 junior. Gives it up on the right side. You were thinking he might just take that himself, but he did a great job of giving it up, got it to Wilbur, and Wilbur scores the bucket.
But Coach Buddenhagen had to take the timeout there.
Yeah. He was trying to wait for the TV timeout, but not able to wait that long, and it didn't look like there was going to be a stoppage in play anytime soon. Roosevelt led by just 3 points a few moments ago. And Roosevelt has really stretched that out.
Mike, it's a final in the State B's, the other consolation semifinal. Hanson defeats Woolsey Wessington 38-36. And at the A tournament in Sioux Falls, consolation round, Clark Willow Lake defeats Chamberlain 41-36.
All right. Kind of low scoring in those games. We've had a lot more points put on the board this afternoon out here. That's Skyler Flatten from Clark Willow Lake. I have not had a chance to see him, but everyone that has and has told me about him, I can't wait to get a chance to see him play next winter.
Biggest lead of the game for the Riders at 14.
Wilbur almost came up with the steal.
Stolen by Howard to Clark, or to Cole, rather. Good ball movement by the Riders. Short range jumper doesn't go for Boggs.
Carr with another rebound.
Pace of the game picking up.
Yeah, Huron getting a little frantic here.
Carr is double teamed, feeds Decker. Down low, oh, and Morrison's gonna go to the free throw line.
The sophomore will be making the trip. The foul there by Nate Cole.
His third.
Foul number five, Nate Cole, that's his third.
Morrison 0-for-1 today.
Buries that one perfectly.
Neutron back in. He's coming in with four fouls. Ledebor goes out.
Not there, and Boggs with the rebound.
Extra pressure by the Tigers. And Hayek has just fouled out of the ballgame. That's going to be his fifth. Tyler will leave the game with 2 points.
The final 3:39 of this game may take quite a while in real time because it's double bonus every time that Huron commits a foul. Roosevelt will be stepping to the line to shoot two, and Tim Budenhagen looking at stretching this game out.
Howard 4 for 6, make it 5 of 7 from the line. All of Howard's points today have come from the line. You're watching the AA Boys Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Last ball game still going on between the boys basketball tournament from the three sites.
Really? Even that double overtime didn't? No, that's right. Yeah.
Castlewood and Hanson will play in the consolation final tomorrow in the B's. Tri-Valley will take on Clark Willow Lake in the A's and Sioux Falls for the consolation round. And the winner of this one gets Brookings tomorrow. The loser gets Rapid City Central.
Oh!
Blocked by Wilbur.
Go, go, gadget arms for Lucas Wilbur. He's got about, I think that's maybe his fourth block shot today.
Missed shot by Decker.
Trying to go with that trap defense, but good read by Roosevelt. Specifically Cole getting out and avoiding the trap.
Roosevelt gonna play a little keep away. Try to run the shot clock down. And
foul gonna be committed though, and that's gonna put Cole at the free throw line. It's gonna go.
Luke Carr is fouled out. He will become the third Huron Tiger to foul out. He will lead the game with 13. Check that, he'll leave with 12. Boy, Nate Cole's been to the line a lot.
Set his.
This will be his 13th free throw. He is 11 of 13 from the free throw line. And 23 points for the 5'9 junior.
Ball is tipped out of bounds. It will stay with Huron.
Ledebor back in for Roosevelt.
Coming out will be Brandon Boggs.
First meeting of the year between these two teams. Which really is a rarity when you think about it.
No
in
kidding.
The AA boys basketball tournament.
Of course, Rough Riders in the GDC, Huron in the ESD.
Nice kisser off the window by Morrison.
How many more years do you suppose we're going to have those? Well, I know the Greater Dakota Conference is going away, but how much longer are we going to have the ESD? Timeout called by Lee Taylor. Lee Taylor, the coach, got the timeout called.
Officials conferring here.
Yep.
And it will be a timeout for Roosevelt. Well, if it's up to the ESD, they'll always have the ESD.
True. Very true. But with the changes that we're seeing at the football level, the
classification levels.
Yep. A couple of years, we're going to be having two big school classes, each with 8 teams in it. I mean, you have to start looking at going with the regional schedule, or it's one of those problems. I'm glad I'm not on the board of control or in the front office of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, because
the population changes continue, big schools, small schools, we're going to see some changes, I think, in the next 4 or 5 years.
Well, remember, there's right around 180 school districts in South Dakota.
Right.
And at least 100 have a ADM number of under 100. 9, 10, 11th grade. That's how they choose the classifications for the classes in South Dakota. It's an absolute challenge geographically and population-wise.
Absolutely right.
It'll always be that way. North Dakota has the same problem. Montana, Wyoming.
Ball kicked out of bounds, and we'll stay with the Rough Riders. Rough Riders going to use some clock here and wrap this thing up.
Austin Sitter in the ball game. Here's the loose ball picked up, and Mr. Morrison goes in with the left hand. He's got seven on the day.
This is a kid I'm going to enjoy watching him. He's a sophomore, but he's really made a solid contribution off the bench in both of these games. He's only averaged 1.1 rebound per game during the course of the season. But
Zach Cranston is fouled out for Huron, the fourth player to foul out. He'll leave with 14.
Will Carr will check into the lineup. 5'11 sophomore. Our third Carr of the day. We had Luke. We had Caleb. Now we got Will.
His 11th free throw of the day is good. 7 of 11 from the line for Howard. Tough pass. Huron still playing hard.
You bet. Going with that trap defense. And now the Rough Rider is going to send in their bench.
Timeout taken by Lee Taylor. He wants to get these guys in. Josh Kirkwold is in. Chris Phillips will come in. Ryan Leslie, a 5'10 sophomore, comes in. Huron will bring in Tate Sporer, a 5'10 sophomore. Huron will bring in Alex Kaufman, a 6'2 junior. JP Noonan, 5'10 sophomore.
And a classy move by both of these coaches, realizing that it's a 15-point game with a minute and a half to go.
It's not going to be J.P. Noonan. He is not dressed for this game. Number 12 is Trey Henderson.
Oh, okay, there we go.
5'11 sophomore. See, we got everyone here for both clubs. We got Leslie. You got Sitter out there for Roosevelt. Kirkwold. Creighton Thompson for the Riders, a 6'2 junior. I think we've got them all in.
I think so, and we've got a foul whistled. Getting into the books is James White, the 6'2 junior, and that's going to put Chris Phillips at the free throw line. And again, classy move by Tim Buddenhagen also. He could have gone with the hack attack and really tried to stretch this thing out, but at about the two-minute mark, he realized that it just wasn't going to happen today, so he had his kids still playing a tough defense, but didn't go with the foul every time that Roosevelt touched the ball.
One more toss here for Chris Phillips. Got them both.
Good for Chris.
You and I are big fans of these guys that get in.
Yeah.
Shoot the ball.
Put the ball in the hole.
Try to score.
That is, as I say, the point of the game.
Here comes Trey Henderson. He'll score it in one. Foul is on Chris Phillips. So Trey Henderson, a sophomore, with a couple coming. No, it was just one. Foul before the shot.
Oh, Who's going to get it? Ball still loose. Now we've got the jump ball.
Lee Taylor put both hands over his eyes. He didn't want to watch at all on that last flurry.
Alternating possession.
We can understand at times.
You better believe it.
But you know what? You got kids out there that seeing some time. And
yeah, what an experience. And that's what, you know, high school activities are all about, the arts.
These guys may not get back.
No, you can never take this for granted. Whether it be band or chorus or debate or theater, it's all about the experience for these kids. Oh, near steal. Shot clock. Oh, and now a traveling violation.
Travel on Creighton Thompson.
I think Creighton will go back and take a look at that tape and perhaps suggest that he was fouled, but
here's Henderson.
Nice backdoor pass.
The shot missed though by Kaufman.
Then the block from behind.
Phillips tried to block it, called for the foul.
Fouls on 33, Josh Kirkwood.
That's going to be on Josh Kirkwood.
James White,
so at the line for the Huron Tigers, James White, 6'2", junior.
That's the ninth team foul.
Come on, James, hit this one.
Roosevelt will play Brookings for the consolation final tomorrow. Huron will play Rapid City Central for seventh place. We'll have that at 1 p.m. Central, noon Mountain tomorrow. Final seconds of the ball game. Riders aren't going to shoot it. They'll just run the clock out, and the Roosevelt Rough Riders will move on to the consolation final. They beat Huron today, 71-56. Here from the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Welcome back to the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center, along with Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, 1230 KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from Calling All Sports with Marco and Mike H. and Sportsmax Radio. This afternoon, we had a pair of games. Our most recent game, it was Sioux Falls-Roosevelt. They led it 17-14 at the end of one, 34-31 at halftime, 47-43 at the end of three, but then in the fourth quarter, they stretched it out, hit some big free throws, and they win over Huron 71-56. Also this afternoon, Brookings picked up the victory over Rapid City Central. Coming up tonight, we've got a couple of semifinals. We'll tell you about those next here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Coming up tonight in our first game, Sioux Falls, Washington will take on Sioux Falls, O'Gorman, and in the nightcap, it will be Pierre taking on Mitchell. Some very entertaining basketball coming your way tonight. 6 Mountain, 7 Central. We'll see you tonight on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Thanks on behalf of all of the men and women who have brought you today's action.